Hey, what's up? This is Cobra for Narco Life, the show where we cover the ongoing war on drugs. Firstly, a shout out and welcome to new and veteran viewers of the channel. You, our audience, are greatly appreciated. Now let's get down to it. Today's episode, we head to Guanajuato State, Mexico, where state legislator and mayoral hopeful Juan Antonio Acosta was murdered. Now, Antonio Acosta was hoping to run for mayor of Juventino Rosas, but authorities said he was killed on Tuesday morning, shot 7 times from behind, then left for dead during his exercise on a downtown street in the city of Juventino Rosas. Acosta, 55, had registered as a National Action Party candidate for mayor of the municipality, where he had served 2 previous terms from 2006 to 2009 and 2012 to 2015. I profoundly lament the killing of State Deputy Juan Antonio Acosta Cana and vehemently condemn these deeds. Guanajuato Governor Diego Sinue Rodriguez Vallejo said on social media, "I call on the State Attorney General's office to investigate this case and bring justice to those responsible." Attorney General Carlos Zamarripa Aguirre has assigned the case to a specialized high-impact crimes unit for investigation, according to a statement by his office. Acosta is the second pre-candidate for the 2021 elections to be killed recently. The first, Antonio Hernandez Jodinez, a Democratic Revolutionary Party hopeful for mayor of Chilapa de Alvarez Guerrero, was shot and killed on November 25th at his construction materials business. It was just a few weeks after he had announced his intention to run for office. Juan Acosta's killing Tuesday cut short a diverse political career. In addition to serving as mayor of Juventino Rosas, he had also served as director of municipal services and as Director General of the DIF Family Services Agency for Guanajuato. State PAN President Roman Cifuentes Negrete said Guanajuato had lost a man committed to Mexico. Staying with Guanajuato, violence in the state, which led the country in homicides last year, has carried on into the new year. 119 people were killed in the first 11 days of 2021. Including 9 members of a family attending a funeral last week in León for a man believed to be a lower-level member of the Santa Rosa de Lima cartel. The man himself had been shot and killed the day before. Now, Juventino Rosas, considered by many to be the territory of the Santa Rosa de Lima cartel, is bordered to the south by Villagran and to the southeast by Silea. The two municipalities were the sites of 5 firefights between security forces and presumed members of the Jalisco New Generation cartel on Monday that left 10 dead, including 1 state police officer. Police attributed those attacks on police to the cartel Jalisco Nueva Generacion and said they had found messages to another unidentified criminal group afterward among the vehicle, explosives, and weapons they confiscated. Now again, sticking with Guanajuato. At the end of 2020, Guanajuato will receive the unenviable title of Mexico's most violent state for a 2nd consecutive year. Official statistics show that 4,190 people were murdered in the Bajío region state between January and November. Guanajuato's homicide count is 58.5% higher than that of Baja California, which ranks 2nd for murders, with 2,643 victims in the first 11 months of the year. Mexico State ranks 3rd, with 2,592 victims, followed by Chihuahua, Jalisco, and Michoacán, with 2,516, 2,421, and 2,229 victims, respectively. There were almost 32,000 homicide victims in Mexico in the first 11 months of 2020, which is likely to surpass 2019 as the most violent year on record. The victim tally between January and November in Guanajuato, where the Cartel Jalisco Nueva Generación and the Santa Rosa de Lima cartel are engaged in a vicious turf war, was 30.5% higher than the same period of 2019. The significant increase has occurred despite Or perhaps because of the arrest of Santa Rosa de Lima cartel leader Jose Antonio Armado Ypez Ortiz in early August. In sheer numbers, Guanajuato was also the most violent state in Mexico in 2019 with more than 3,500 homicide victims. In per capita terms, it was the fifth most violent state with 44.95 homicides per 100,000 residents. Colima ranked first, followed by Baja California, Chihuahua, and Morelos. Guanajuato is not the only state that has seen an increase in homicide numbers in 2020. 11 Mexican states recorded more murders between January and November of this year compared to the same period in 2019. Zacatecas saw the sharpest increase, with the number of victims increasing 64.9% to 935 from 567 murdered. Yucatan recorded the second biggest increase, but its homicide numbers remain very low. There were 43 murder victims in that state between January and November 2020, a 53.6% increase compared to the 28 victims in the same period last year. Homicides increased 47.4% to 672 in San Luis Potosí and 22.5% in Michoacán to 2,229. Sonora, Durango, Campeche, Querétaro, Chihuahua, and Hidalgo recorded increases of between 1% and 18%. Now, 2021 looks like it won't be any different with the start the year has gotten off to. This is El Cobra, signing off for Narco Life. Please like, share, comment, ring the notification bell so you don't miss any uploads, and watch some more OG Black Show episodes and subscribe to the channel to help the OG Black Show grow. Gracias.